This is CJ with the WCCO Radio's John Hines. We're at the St. Paul Yacht and Pool Club, situated next to the Mississippi River on this rainy day. Having never yachted or pooled with Hines, I had never seen his calf tattoo.
It's a daredevil, a fishing lure. Anybody who's ever fished in Minnesota, you can go into any old-timer's tackle box and you'll see two things, a daredevil and a lazy Ike. The reason I did this, when I was 9 years old, fishing at my grandfather's place in St. Cloud, on the river just north of Sartell, I went like this, and put a hook so deep in my leg, I went, you know, the little, and I was fine until I looked at it. Then I screamed like a child, and when I went to the doctor to have the doctor remove it, the doctor came in and went, oh, geez. And when the doctor winces, you know it's problematic. It was fine. So anyway, I just thought, I'll put that there. That's a reminder of what happened.
So since getting this little daredevil, Hines ran the idea of getting another tattoo by his adult sons.
You can't. Because I was telling him what I was thinking about on my arm. He said, I can't. I said, okay, why can't I? He said, you don't have the arms for it. Like, thanks, son. You get them here and they'll just bring you down a peg.
Yeah. Brace yourselves, boys. Dad may soon have the biceps for tattoo number two. That's because Hines is planning even more time at the gym, at which he's already a regular, when he's not on one of his 50-mile bicycle rides.
I'm really healthy.
That's a good reason.
I'm going to become annoyingly healthy going forward. I ride bicycle. I love to ride my bicycle. I had my knee replaced recently, and I can now, this kind of weather, a day like this, 70-some degrees, it's a little muggy, but I could still go out and ride my bicycle for 40 to 50 miles in a day, just riding around.
And now he'll have the time to do that a lot more. Hines is retiring from a 45-year Twin Cities broadcasting career, the last night of which he spent at WCCO. John Hines has used his mellifluous vocal cords to be undeniably amusing throughout his career. But I'll always remember something rather poignant Hines said to me a few years ago when we were having dinner, during which we discovered we were both going through peculiar divorces. He told me, you can get over the pain, but you can never get over the doubt. Brilliant.
That was a relationship that went way south.
It hurts less than...
Oh, yes. Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. Because that was... this is going to be so vague to anybody who's watching this. You're going to go, what's he talking about?
I'm only going to do 5 minutes, so who knows if it will
make the cut. You edit the heck out of this. Edit away. Do whatever you have to do to edit this. But, that was one... I've always joked about this, and it's not funny. I've had, three marriages. My son's mother... the best of all times. This is maybe why we're still close. We're still parenting together.
Is she the first one?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
But there was, I always said, well, if looking within, I was the one common denominator in all of those.
Yes, you were.
Yes, I was. Yes, I
and
was.
And now you know you should have just stayed with that woman, don't you?
Perhaps. Perhaps. But you know what? My sons are happy. Between the two of us, mostly her, we raised two brilliant young men. And I've said this many times. They are both better men, better husbands, and better fathers than their father was. And that's the best you can hope for.
Yeah.
That those who come behind you do better than you did.
How many grandkids do you have?
I have a total of five.
Okay.
Three in Ireland, and two here in the Twin Cities. Actually, my son here lives in the house where I was raised.
Oh, sweet.
He got that house for my mother, bought that house for my mother.
Wow.
So, yeah. That's part of what I'm going to do as I step back, step away. I'll spend some more time with the kids and the grandkids.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So, do you have a wife now?
No, ma'am.
Okay. I was like, God, it took you three times to figure out you shouldn't do that again.
I have a wonderful relationship. She lives on the second floor. I live in the third floor.
Oh.
When I walk her home, it takes 8 seconds. If I walk her home. Otherwise, I just listen for the door to click. Okay, you got it. But my son's mother once said to me, if we had had a duplex or a double bungalow, we could probably still be married. You just go home, and I'll go home. So